अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू माय इंग्लिश क्लास स्टैंडर्ड 7। आज हम देख रहे हैं 4.5 फ्रॉम द सेल्फिश जायंट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट 4.5 फ्रॉम द सेल्फिश जायंट। ऑस्कर फिंगल ओ फर्दलिटी विल वाइल्ड वॉज अ आयरिश प्ले राइटर, नॉवलिस्ट, इजीएस्ट एंड अ पोएट। द सेल्फिश जायंट इज अ short fantasy story for children which revolves around a giant who builds a wall to keep children out of his garden but learn compassion from the innocent of the children। selfish giant ek fantasy story hai, khayali kahani hai bachcho ke liye, jo ek giant ek rakshas jise kahenge uske around ghumti hai, jo apne jo hai गार्डन के अतराफ में जो है बाउंड्री वॉल बना देता है ताकि बच्चे वहाँ पर ना आए। लेकिन वो किस तरह से अपने ख्याल बदलता है, वो इनोसेंट बच्चों को देखकर, भोले भाले बच्चों को देखकर, वो हम इस स्टोरी में देखेंगे। ठीक है, तो हम शुरू करते हैं स्टोरी फ्रॉम द सेल्फिश जायंट। एवरी आफ्टरनून एज दे वेर कमिंग फ्रॉम द स्कूल, द चिल्ड्रन यूज टू गो एंड प्ले इन द जायंट्स गार्डन। It was a large, lovely garden with soft green grass. Here and there over the grass stood beautiful flowers like stars, and there were 12 people peach trees that is in the springtime broke out into delicate blossom of pink and pearl, and in the autumn before reach fruit. The birds sat on the trees and sang so sweetly that the children used to stop their games in order to listen to them. How happy we are, they cried to each other. One day the giant came back. He had been to visit his friend the Cornish ogre and had stayed with him for 7 years. After the 7 years he determined to return to his own castle. When he arrived he saw the children playing with the in the garden. What are you doing here? He cried in a very guffaw voice, and the children ran away. My own garden, in my own garden, said the giant. Anyone can understand that, and I will allow nobody to play in but myself. So he built a high wall all around it and put up a notice board. Trespasser will be prosecuted. He was a very selfish giant. The poor children had now nowhere to play. They tried to play on the road, but the road was very dusty and full of hard stones, and they did not like it. They used to wander around the high walls when their lessons were over and talk about the beautiful garden inside. How happy we were there, they said to each other. Then the spring came, and all over the country there were little blossoms and little birds. Only in the garden of the selfish giant it was still winter. The birds did not care to sing in it as there were no children, and the trees forgot to blossom. Once a beautiful flower put his head out of the grass, but when it saw the notice board it was so sorry for the children that it slipped back into the ground again and went off to sleep. The only people who were pleased were the snow and the forest. Spring has forgotten this garden, they cried. So we will live here all the year around. The snow covered up the grass with a great white cloth, and the forest painted all over the trees silver. Then they invited the north wind to stay with them. And he came. He was wrapped in furs, and he rolled all day about the garden and blew the chimney pots down. This is a delight spot, he said. We must ask the hail to visit. So he hail come every day for 3 hours. He rattled over the roof of the castle till he broke most of the slate, and then he ran around the garden as fast as he could. He was dressed in a gray and his breath was like ice. आई कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड वाई द स्प्रिंग इज सो लेट इज कमिंग सेट द सेल्फिश जायंट एज ही सेट एट द विंडो एंड लुक एट दिस कोल्ड वाइट गार्डन आई होप देर विल बी अ चेंज इन द वेदर बट द स्प्रिंग नेवर केम नॉर द समर द ऑटमन गेव गोल्डन फ्रूट टू एवरी गार्डन बट द जायंट्स गार्डन गेव नन ही इज टू सेल्फिश ही सेड सो इट वॉज ऑलवेज विंटर देर.